The Mirror for Magistrates. The Induction by Thomas Sackville. The wrathful winter, approaching on apace, with blustering blasts had o'erly barred the treen, and old Saturnus with his frosty face, with chilling cold had pierced the tender green, the mantles rent wherein enwrapped been, the gladsome groves that now lay overthrown, the tappets torn, and every bloom downblown. The soil, that erst so seemly was to seen, was all despoiled of her beauty's hue, and soot-fresh flowers, wherewith the summer's queen had clad the earth, now Boreas blasts down blue, and small fowls flocking in their song did rue the winter's wrath, wherewith each thing defaced, in woeful wise bewailed the summer past. Hawthorn had lost his motley livery, the naked twigs were shivering all for cold, and dropping down the tears abundantly. Each thing, methought, with weeping eye me told, the cruel season bidding me withhold myself within, for I was gotten out into the fields, whereas I walked about. When lo, the night with misty mantles spread, gan dark the day and dim the azure skies, and Venus in her message Hermes sped to bloody Mars to will him not to rise, which she herself approached in speedy wise, and Virgo hiding her disdainful breast, with Thetis now had laid her down to rest. While Scorpio, dreading Sagittarius's dart, whose bow press bent in fight, the string had slipped, down slid into the ocean flood apart. The bear that in the Irish seas had dipped his grisly feet with speed from thence he whipped. For Thetis, hasting from the virgin's bed, pursued the bear, that ere she came was fled. And Phaeton now, near reaching to his race, with glistering beams, gold streaming where they bent, was pressed to enter in his resting place. Eurytheus, that in the cart first went, had even now attained his journey's stent, and fast declining hid away his head, while Titan couched him in his purple bed. And pale Cynthia, with her borrowed light, beginning to supply her brother's place, was past the noonstead 6 degrees in sight, when sparkling stars amid the heaven's face with twinkling light shone on the earth apace. That while they brought about the night's chair, the dark had dimmed the day, ere I was ware. And sorrowing I to see the summer flowers, the lively green, the lusty leaves forlorn, the sturdy tree so shattered with the showers, the field so fade that flourished so beforn, it taught me well all earthly things be born, to die the death for naught long time may last. The summer's beauty yields to winter's blast.